there is about between Paddy Fitzsimmons of Ireland, number 129, and Piotr Gutman of Poland, number 216. Gutman, European silver medalist in the 1961 championship, giving young Fitzsimmons from Belfast, a fruit porter, a very hard time indeed. And this looks like a compulsory standing count. It is. Gutman, a tough little man who's dominated this contest from the start. Fitzsimmons taking the eighth, standing up. There's not long to go in this last round, but I think these last few seconds are going to be extremely tough for Paddy Fitzsimmons. The pole is just that bit too strong for him, a very fine Polish southpaw. He must be fancied to win the gold medal in this featherweight competition. Fitzsimmons has been under pressure right from the first belt. This last round has been the toughest of all. But a game little red-haired boy sticking it to the last. There's the bell to end it. Fine performance to stay there by Fitzsimmons, and an even better performance by the Polish southpaw, Gutman. And up come the judges scoring that row of sixes at the bottom, all for Gutman.
And now, more success for this part of the world. Yesterday, the Irishman, Sean McCafferty, was matched against Carbonell of Cuba in a flyweight preliminary bout. Harry Carpenter was at the ringside. Where else has he been these past days?
The Irish southpaw flyweight, Sean McCafferty, number 127, comes out to meet Rafael Carbonell of Cuba in the flyweight first series bout here at the Korakuen Ice Palace, Tokyo. Number 127, the Irish southpaw and All-Ireland champion, Sean McCafferty, who comes from Belfast. Meeting here, a young Cuban, Rafael Carbonell, number 61. And the Cuban has got his man in trouble already in the first round, in the opening seconds. Not even 40 seconds elapsed so far. And McCafferty finding this coloured Cuban quite a handful. A hooker and a swinger is number 61, Carbonell from Cuba. And getting through with that right hand, the traditional medicine for the southpaw, getting in close against McCafferty, who seems a little bit overawed and overwhelmed by his first appearance in the Olympic Games. McCafferty completely taken out of his stride and out of his boxing. McCafferty now trying to retreat and box behind the southpaw right lead. Using his feet now to try and gain time to get his breath back and settle down into some sort of rhythm. He was completely taken out of it in the opening seconds. McCafferty, only 19, a big occasion for him. And his face now looking extremely red around the left eye. McCafferty showing signs at the end of the first of settling down and now beginning to try to work behind his southpaw right lead. He's got the reach advantage, and I would suspect probably the boxing skill, if he can only get his rhythm going here and not allow this Cuban to get in too close and hustle him. Question here is whether the Cuban is going to have the strength to keep going at this furious pace that he's set right through the three rounds. Definite signs that the Cuban is beginning to slow a little. Boxing now in spasms. And McCafferty's punching now beginning to look a lot heavier and more authoritative. Complete contrast in styles. The much taller McCafferty, about 5 foot five, against the 5 foot 1 inch flyweight from Cuba, Rafael Carbonell. Complete contrast in styles between these two. The correct southpaw style, upright style of McCafferty, and and the crouching and hooking, bustling tactics of Carbonell. Well, the judges have said that they're looking for correct boxing tactics in these games, and on that standard, then McCafferty ought to have won this one all right. He was worried in the first minute, but since then he's been managing to more or less command the bout. And now the punches are beginning to rain into the Cuban's face as he tries to come forward. And McCafferty has very much got this one in the bag if he can keep this up. This last round has easily been McCafferty's best. The Irish champion has really dominated it with good, straight, correct punching against the oncoming and tiring Cuban. I don't think Carbonell really knows what day it is. Now he can hardly stand up. He's so tired. McCafferty of Ireland, the 19-year-old southpaw from Belfast, who wins that bout against Carbonell of Cuba, Ireland's first winner in this Olympic tournament. Lightweight bout, first series between Jim McCourt of Ireland, number 130, and Bunnam Su of Korea. The Korean number 164. Against the Irish southpaw from Belfast, Jim McCourt, an apprentice joiner, 20 years old. The Koreans have fielded one or two quite useful boxers in this Olympic tournament. We'll see now how Jim McCourt handles this one. McCourt, the Irish champion. Seems to have settled down quite fast, beginning to use his southpaw right lead well. Korean looks principally to be a hooker. Korean trying to trap the cord against the ropes. Bruin's got very fast hands indeed. He punches like lightning. Shoulder. Half a minute left of the first round. Caught picking his punches well. Good straight rights, catching the Korean as he comes in. Looks like a good start by McCourt. Some boys don't settle down early in an Olympic bout, but McCourt certainly has. Tour this lightweight bout between number 130, Jim McCourt, the Irish southpaw champion, and Bunnam Su of Korea. McCourt settled down quickly in this bout. The first round he was very quickly into his stride, taking it coolly, punching straight, accurate right leads, catching the advancing Korean. The Korean is a fast puncher, but not quite fast enough to beat the footwork of McCourt. Court is one of the Irish team's big hopes. Last season in Britain, he twice outpointed Jimmy Dunn, the ABA champion. Dunn, who is already through to the last 16 of the lightweights. Footwork didn't work that time, and McCourt for once got caught. Coming up to the halfway stage of the second round. The Korean is a bit puzzled by the southpaw stance of McCourt. McCourt taking this one very coolly and boxing extremely well. Nice demonstration of the way to pick up points against an advancing and hooking opponent. Not doing much body punching, McCourt. Putting him in all to the head. Final round of this lightweight first series bout between Jim McCourt of Ireland, the Irish champion, southpaw from Belfast, and the Korean number 164, Bun Nam Soo, who so far seems to be lagging on points. That at least is on my card. McCourt very quickly settled down into his rhythm in the first round. He's boxed a cool fight. He's always been poking his right hand into the face of the advancing Korean. Soo, the Korean, is really boxing the sort of fight that suits McCourt. McCourt likes the man to come to him, and he wants to pick him off, and this is what he's trying to do. Monsieur Gondre, French referee, telling them both to be careful with their heads. I wouldn't think there have been many boxers in this tournament that we've seen so far who've got better footwork than McCourt. It really is delightful. Great economy of movement. Still the same pattern. McCourt letting the Korean come onto his punching. Beautiful. A minute left, and unless something drastically goes wrong now, it's looking very much as though Jim McCourt, the Irish champion from Dominic Savio Club Belfast, is going to be like his flyweight colleague Sean McCafferty through to the last 16 of his weight. Korean now making a last effort in this last half minute. Wonderfully controlled piece of boxing by Jim McCourt of Ireland.
The winner, red corner,
Jim McCourt, the Irish champion, after a very fine and intelligent bout, goes through to the last 16 of the lightweights, where he'll meet Sawa of Pakistan. Light welterweight division, first round proper for Ireland, number 131, Brian Anderson, a southpaw, born in Donegal but lives in London, and his opponent from Cambodia, pretty much an unknown quantity, Touch Noll, T-O-U-C-H, Noll, N-O-L. Both of them southpaws. The brown-skinned Noll, quite a bit taller than Anderson. Brian Anderson for Ireland. The boy who came into the Irish team at the last moment when Jim Neal was declared unfit. Well, Touch Noll is quite a useful quantity. Cambodian anxious to get on with it, and no wonder. This is very reminiscent of the contest that Ronnie Smith had the other night with the Burmese that we didn't know much about. And here is this Cambodian, tall, strong-looking, an awkward southpaw, which I don't suppose Anderson much likes. Anderson now moving on the retreat, try and feel his way back. Very much outreached. Just over halfway through the first round. Anderson seems to have recovered fully and is beginning to box a little better now. Moving back nicely and scoring the good rights and lefts of the head. Anderson looking very composed now against this swarthy Cambodian. Well, this is a good recovery by Brian Anderson after a very bad start. Beginning to find the range nicely now and beginning to pick up a lot of useful points as the first round comes to a close. It's the last round now between Brian Anderson of Ireland and Touch Noll of Cambodia in this light welterweight contest in the first round proper. With Anderson having recovered well from a first round knockdown in the first minute and a half. During the second round, he picked up a lot of points by boxing skillfully on the retreat against a much taller southpaw opponent. Most of Anderson's good work has been done with neat counters to the head. Consistently beating the Cambodian to the punch. A touch of desperation from Touch Noll. Must be frustrating indeed for this Cambodian after that early success. Since then, he's hardly laid a really good glove. on the Irishman. Well, it's been a beautiful bit of retrieving by Brian Anderson. The other day we had Jimmy Dunn getting up off the floor to pound out a points win, and it looks very much as though Brian Anderson, barring all accidents now, is going to do the same. And that could be one of the accidents. He caught a left hand there, which was a good punch. There's 1 minute to go. Cambodia now is looking for just one big punch. But it looks as though Brian Anderson, the Irish builder's labourer who lives in Cricklewood, London, is boxing his way to a good win here after being down in the first round against Tuchnell of Cambodia. A really good performance by the 25-year-old Irishman. And Null has got the decision, and I would regard that as one of the most extraordinary decisions I've seen in these Tokyo boxing contests so far.
10 out of 5. Jimmy McCourt has survived, and in his second series bout, flyweight Sean McCafferty had a great battle with Chitu of Ghana. McCafferty is wearing the white shorts, his number 127.
Not working behind that long left at all. Has that right hand, and McCafferty has to back away. They're boxing for a place in the last eight. Now Chitu has suddenly taken command with the right hand, and he's hurt McCafferty more than once in these last 30 seconds. Half a minute to go in the second round of this flyweight second series bout between McCafferty of Ireland and Suri Chitu of Ghana, with the Ghanaian having scored one or two heavy successes with his right hand. Third and final round of this flyweight second series bout between number 127, Sean McCafferty from Belfast, representing the Irish team, and Suri Chitu of Ghana, the hard-hitting, tall 19-year-old boy from Africa. It looks to me as though McCafferty is lagging a little bit on points. He had a rather hard second round, particularly in the latter half of it, when Chitu's right hand began to come very much into play. The right hand which knocked out Chitu's first opponent in these Olympics in the first round. He hasn't had that sort of success against McCafferty, who's an intelligent boxer. But it certainly has taken a lot of the steam out of McCafferty. The Irish southpaw trying to use his feet and his right hand to score, to slip the leads and get inside if he can. It's proving a very tough job. McCafferty has hardly thrown a body punch from the first bell. Well, it's fairly clear now as we get to the last half minute that there isn't going to be too much between them, barring accidents. It's a question of whether the judges think the right hand work and aggression of Sheetu has outbalanced the more skillful countermeasures of the Irishman.
So McCafferty won, and he goes on to the quarterfinals, where he'll meet Elzoni of Italy. Result there, a win for the Irish boy, McCafferty.
Boxer Jimmy McCourt of Belfast became their one and only medal winner when he won his way through to the semi-finals of the lightweight class. Now, this assured him and Ireland of a bronze.
Jim McCourt boxing for Ireland, and trying hard to get amongst the gold or the silver. He's assured of a bronze, being in the semi-final, because both losing some finalists get a bronze medal. Jim McCourt boxing Valikhtin Baranikov of Russia. McCourt number 130. Intriguing battle of southpaws here. Both these boys showing a lot of respect for each other's ability, as well they might. Both of them extremely experienced. McCourt, although only 20 years old, the most experienced member of the Irish boxing team. He's had 162 bouts and lost only 13 of them. Baranikov, 26-year-old student, the teacher's training institute at Moscow. 216 bouts he's had and lost 18. McCourt tending to wait to let Baranikov bring it to him. And the Russian willing to do that. Can switch the point of attack from head to body very effectively. McCourt represented Ireland in the European Championships. Coming out for the third and final round in this lightweight bout, 9 stone, 7 pounds division, semi-final. McCourt last year senior and junior champion of Ulster and All-Ireland. Both these boxers already won 3 times on their way to the final. McCourt beat Shu of Korea, Sawa of Pakistan, and Barrera of Spain. Baranikov accounted for Zunico of Chile, Blair, the Australian Aborigine, and a Hungarian, Kaji. Oh, that was a good one. Traditional way for the orthodox boxer to stand up to a southpaw to give him plenty of right hand treatment, but when two southpaws meet, they just have to work it out as it comes. McCourt livening up a little bit now, not tending to play the waiting game quite so much, but making the head his target all the time. He's drawing a smear of blood from Baranikov's nose. The Russian impressive by the way he does switch the attack from head to body on occasions. That's Baranikov when he gets inside. Shoots to the head. That's certainly a grandstand finish there. It's a close one, but it's Baranikov who gets the decision. Baranikov goes on to the final.
And McCourt had to be content with the bronze.